Hey, good morning, students. So let's start today's session. The session is going to be network model. So yesterday we have seen the definition of cyber security and what are the importance of cyber security we have seen in the yesterday's class. And before that, we have also seen what are the basic concepts of computer networks. So in that, we have seen what are the definition of a computer network and what is meant by computer communications, how we can go for designing a network, and what are the connecting devices available to form a LAN setup. Okay, the connecting devices which we have seen yesterday are network interface card, then routers, bridges, repeaters, gateway. So all these we have seen. These are the connecting devices used to form a computer networking. Then we have seen what are the types of LAN. There is what are the types of networks we have seen: LAN, MAN, WAN, PAN, and CAN. Students, I hope you might have across all these, you have cleared with the yesterday's session. Okay, let's move on to today's session. That is network model. Okay, the objective of today's session is to know about the network model, and the outcome of the session may be the students may be able to understand the basic concepts of OSI model and TCP/IP model. So these two models are called as reference model. Okay, we are going to see all the these two models in today's session. And these are the outlines of today's session. We are going to see the layer task, that is the functionality of each layer in OSI model and also in the TCP/IP model. Okay. The network models which we are going to see, the two models we are going to see, that is OSI model and TCP/IP model. So in under the OSI model, we are going to see what is all about the OSI model, what are the layers which forms the OSI model, and what is the functionality of each layer. We are going to see all these. And next thing we are going to see is addressing. So in case of addressing, we can go for four types of addressing. One is the physical address, the next one is logical address, third one is port address, and the last one is specific addresses. So what are the usage of these addresses, and these addresses are used in specific layers also. So all this we are going to cover in today's session. From one place to another place, that is hardware. And software is consisting of instruction set. So that is providing the service to the network, that is to the users. So that is called software. So these two combination, we call it as a network. And we are going to see what are the possible modes of communication in the network. So there are three modes that are possible. One is point-to-point communication. The other one is broadcasting. The other one is multicasting. Okay. So coming on to the point to point, it will be the communication will be a dedicated one. So what is going to be a dedicated one? The transfer of message will be a reliable one. Okay. So you can also have the shared communication, that is called multicasting. So in dedicated mode of communication, you can have three types. One is simplex mode, half duplex, and full duplex. So these three types are there. We'll see these are available transmission modes. First one is simplex transmission mode. So that is any node can transmit the message only in one direction, either in a forward direction or in a backward direction. For example, take television. So only the user can receive or view some images or videos, audios from the television. So it's a one-way communication. So we call that as a simplex transmission mode. The next one is half duplex transmission mode. So in this, the transmission is possible only in either direction, that is also only one way at a time. For example, a police radio, that is they will be holding some walkie talkie, you might have seen. Okay, so either a person or a policeman can receive the message from the another policeman. Okay, that's a example for half duplex transmission mode. And the next, third mode is full duplex, that is both the directions the transmission is possible at the same time. That is only it can go for transmitting the messages and receiving the messages. So that is possible. For the best example is telephonic conversation between one person to another person. Okay. So that's what about the point-to-point communication. Broadcasting means you are going to transmit the messages in a particular channel. Okay. Then it's also a dedicated mode and can also have the shared mode. That is multiple access. So shared access means it can go for sharing your multiple messages from one place to another place. So multicasting mode of communication means it is between the point to point and the broadcasting. Okay. So it is restricted to only specific group of people. The communication is restricted to specific group of people and not to all the others. Broadcasting means you are broadcasting the message to all other persons in a network. Okay. And these are the three transmission modes which we have seen. Okay, next we can see what is meant by protocol. So where we can see this protocol? So in each and every layer that we are going to see in OSI model and TCP/IP model, protocol plays the main role. Okay, what is meant by protocol? That is the set of rules and regulations that we are going to follow for the reliable communication to take place. That is called protocol. Okay, so these are protocols are the main building blocks of a network. And each protocol may be having two object, two interfaces. So one will be the service interface, the other one is the peer-to-peer interface. So what is meant by service interface? That is, so each layer will be performing some functionality, and the lower level will be accessing the services provided by the upper layer. Okay, and also in the that is will be the same thing will be placed in the receiver side as well as in the sender side also. So the main thing we are going to notice that each layer's services will be acquired by the other layer. Okay, so that is the service interface that is defining the operations on this protocol. And peer-to-peer interface means the messages that is going to be exchanged from one node to another node. That is peer-to-peer interface. Okay, so we are going to see the what are the functionalities of layers. So the best example we can take it is in a daily life, that we can consider two friends who can communicate or transfer the message through the postal mail. Okay. A sender will be there, a receiver will be there. So sender will be writing some letter to the receiving receiver. So the in between you can see some transformation of message will be carried out. So who will be carrying the message? The postman will be carrying the letter to the post office. Then again from the source post office to the destination post office there will be communication. Okay, we are going to see the one friend sends a letter to the another friend. So this is the pictorial representation of how the communication is carried out between the sender and the receiver. First, the sender will be writing the letter and putting it in an envelope and dropping in a mailbox. And the letter is carried from mailbox to a particular post office. Consider the sender from the, maybe from the Salem, and consider the receiver maybe from the nearby city, that is Karur or Coimbatore, etc. We can assume like that. Okay, the letter is delivered by the carrier to the post office. So here the layer will be maintained. So lower level, middle level, and higher level. So each layer will be acquiring the services of the middle, that is next nearby level. So the sender will be acquiring the services which is provided by the middle layer, and the middle layer will be acquiring the services provided by the lower layer. In the same way, receiver side also it is maintained. Okay. So from the post office of Karur or Coimbatore, it will be delivered to the mailbox, and the receiver will be receiving the corresponding message. Okay. So one of the things we have seen from the previous example is the components. There is the three main components playing a role. They are sender, receiver, and carrier. And what is the hierarchy? So the layers exist on both the sides, and these layers are arranged in order. Okay, that is order in the sense. So it has to maintain the hierarchy. So okay, the next thing is services. So each layer at the sending side as well as in the receiving side, they will be providing some service to the nearby layers, immediate layers which is below it. While at the sending side, it will use the services rendered by the upper layer will be rendering the acquiring the services by the lower layer, and at the receiving side also it provides the services to the layer immediately above it. So at the sending side, the layers will be acquiring the upper layer will be acquiring the services from the lower layer. At the receiving side, the layers which is at the that at the upper layer will be providing the service to the above layer. That's the concept here. Okay, we'll see about the two types of reference model. One is the OSI model, the expansion is the open system interconnection model, and the other thing is TCP/IP model. Okay, so what is meant by ISO? It's a standard. You might have seen ISO standard is seen everywhere in whatever the things we have purchased, we are purchasing, you can identify that ISO standard there. It was established in the year 1947, and it's nothing but the International Standards Organization, which is a multinational body dedicated to the worldwide agreement on the international standards. So what is OSI? It is Open System Interconnection Standard. It covers all the network communications. So it was the first model, first introduced in the late 1970s. And you can see all these are seven layers in OSI model. And the first layer is physical layer. The second layer is data link layer. And the third layer is network layer. Fourth layer, transport layer. Fifth one is session layer. Then sixth one is presentation. And the seventh layer is application layer. So among the seven layers, the first three layers, physical layer, data link layer, and network layer, we call these are the network support layers. So all these layers will be dealing with the physical aspects of transmitting the message or data from one node to another node, or one device to another device. And transport layer will be ensuring the reliable data transmission. There is the end-to-end transmission is reliability is confirmed in the transport layer. And the above three layers, session layer, presentation layer, and application, we call these three layers are the user support layers. Okay, and this will be allowing interoperability among the unrelated software systems. Okay, and here in this slide we can see what are the data represented at each and every layer. So in the physical layer, at the physical layer, the data is represented by bits, that is zeros and ones representation. Okay, at the data link layer, the data is represented as a frame. So the data will be we can see the data as a frame format. And in the network layer, we can see data is represented as a packet. Data packets we'll be seeing. And in the transport layer, segments, we call that as a segment, data segment. And session layer, presentation layer, and demo application layer, all these layers we call the data as a data itself. Okay. And the below layers we call that as the physical layer and data link layer and network layer. All these are called as media layers, and the above layers are called as host layers. So in this we can see how the data is encapsulated. What do you mean the encapsulation? That is, you are having the data which is added, you are going to add some more additional information to the data. That is encapsulation. Combining or extra information about the data is added. Okay, that is data encapsulation. And in the physical layer, you can see the bits will be transferred from sender to the receiver. It will be in the form of zeros and ones. And in the data link layer, you can see data header and the data trailer will be added upon to the data. Okay. And in the network layer, network header will be added on to the data. And in the transport layer, transport header will be added on to the data. And session header is added on to the data at the session level, session layer. And presentation header is also added on to the data format in the presentation. And at the application layer, the data is transmitted to the user over at the receiving side. Okay. So this is what about the data encapsulation. And this is the functionality of each and every layer in OSI model. So regarding the physical layer, it all deals with the transmission of electrical signals. So at the physical layer, you can go on using the connecting devices like cables, hubs, etc. Okay, let me see one by one. Okay, so this is the interaction between the layers in the OSI model. And you can see this in this picture, device A is going to be transfer the message to the device B. So each and every layer is having the interface. So between the physical and the data link layer, you can have a 2-in-1 interface. Likewise, each and between the every layer, you can have the interface will be acting. So what is in the interface? They'll be providing the service to the nearby layers. Okay. And you can also see in this picture, two routers are connected in between device A and device B. So they are acting as intermediate node. The transfer of message will be through the router and reaching the device B. So in the fourth layer, fifth layer and seventh, you can see peer-to-peer protocol will be acting on that. Okay, you'll see the functionality of each and every layer. So we are going to see layered architecture. In the introduction session, we have discussed all these topics, layer architecture, how the peer-to-peer process is carried out, and what are the data, how the data is encapsulated in at each and every layer we have seen. So this is the layer architecture of seven layers in OSI model, and this is the peer-to-peer processes. We have seen at each and every layer, you'll be having the interface, which are nothing but the services, set of services, provided to the each and every nearby layers. Okay, and peer-to-peer protocol is also acting upon from fourth layer to seventh layer. Okay, and this is the encapsulation we have seen. So in this, you can notice that at the data link layer only, you can add the header and the trailer, not in the other layers. So network layer, transport layer, and session presentation, all the header parts will be added on to the data format. So then bits will be transferred to the through the transmission medium, and it will be reaching the destination node. Okay. So we'll be seeing, we can go on seeing the functionality of the physical layer. So the main functionality of physical layer is to see how the transmission of bits is carried out. That's the main responsibility of the physical layer. So it is always implemented through the hardware. So already we have seen network is the combination of hardware and the software. So hardware, in the sense, we can go for that is can go for defining the connecting devices. So what are the connecting devices used to set up the network? So that is implemented through the hardware. We can go for implementing this. Next it is encompasses the mechanical interfaces, electrical and functional interfaces. Mainly focus on the error detection also. Okay, in the transmission, what are the errors occurring? It is physical layer will be dealing all these. Okay, data link layer. It has the main responsibility of how the frames of transmitted. So at the data link layer, it can the data will be represented as a frame. Okay, we can see the main responsibility is to have a error-free transmission of data, reliable transmission of data, and error correction will be there, and access control. So all these will be carried out by the data link layer. Okay, so and it can also have the messages like establishing the connection and acknowledging the connection between the peer-to-peer, that is from one node to another, that will be confirmed. Then poll or select, that is used, that commands will be sent between sender to receiver for establishing the proper communication in the primary and the secondary devices also. And it will also take care of the flow control of the transmission also, and the stop and wait. So these are the signals which will be useful for establishing the connections. Coming on to the network layer, it is used mainly, routing of packets will be carried out at the network layer. So routing of packets means, so how the at the network layer will be data is represented as a packet. Okay, so mainly the network layer will be responsible for routing of messages through the network, and we will be concerning about the types of switching used. So regarding the switching concepts, there are three types of switching is carried out in the network. One is circuit switching, second one is packet switching, and the third one is message switching. So mainly we'll be concentrating on circuit switching and packet switching. Okay, so network layer will be choosing which type of switching is applicable. Okay, and it also handles the routing between the networks also, as well as through the packet switching networks. Okay, and coming on to the transport layer, it deals with how the packets are sent to the above layer, that is the application layer. So it is concerned with the reliable transfer of message from one application to another application. It also includes the aspects like flow control, error checking. All these will be managed by the transport layer. And in this transport layer, it also do the function of breaking down the message size also. If the message is too long, then it can go for compressing also. That will be done by the transport layer, and it also isolates the message from the upper layer and the lower layer also. And coming on to the session layer, mainly the management of the sessions. So managing the connections will be carried out by the session layer. That is session in the sense, first if you want to transfer any information from sender to receiver, first they have to establish a connection between the logical connection between sender to receiver. Then they have to go for, after transmission, they have to go for terminating the connection at the end of the session. So it's similar to like if you're going for transferring the amount from one account to another account, then if you are going to transfer money from one person to another person, you will be going for internet banking. So the session will be open for the particular user. If your the transfer of amount is completed in a successful manner, the session will be closed. So if the time takes too long, then you may have noticed the message like the session expired. Okay, so that session management will be managed by the session layer. Okay, so that is managing log on, password exchange, and log offs. All these will be carried out by the session layer. And presentation layer, So encoding and decoding, or in other words, we can say encryption and decryption of the data will be done at the presentation layer. So encoding in the sense, you can go for using the encryption algorithms, and at the receiver side, you can go for using the decryption algorithm. Whatever the sender is sending the original information, that will be decrypted by the receiver at the destination point. Okay, and presentation layer will be also providing the format and code conversion services also. And application layer, it provides access to the network for the end users. So the end users or the main persons who will be receiving services at the application layer. Okay, users' capabilities are determined. So what items are available at this application layer. Okay. So this is what the pictorial representation of how the physical layer, what are the bits will be transmitted to the transmission media. So mainly the physical layer is responsible for the transmission of individual bits from one node to the another node, that is from source to destination. And coming on to the data link layer, the data link layer is responsible for movement of the frames. So at the data link layer, you can have the data representation as the frames. So data movement, or that is frame. So frame will be represented as header and the trailer will be encapsulated with that of the data. Okay. And what is meant by hop to hop delivery? So hop in the sense, you can clearly see. So here, A is the end system, and D and F for the three systems connected in a network via three routers. Okay, B, C, and E are the in-between system, or we call this as a router, which is connecting the three devices. Suppose, consider the end system A is going to transfer the message to the end system F. Okay, so what is going to be hop to hop delivery in the sense? So from the end system A, there is a link is established between the end system A and the intermediate system B. From A to B, you are having the hop-to-hop delivery. Okay? From B to E, that is B to E intermediate, that is B router to E router, you will be having a hop-to-hop. So hop in the sense, one node to another node. Okay? That is the distance, we call that as a hop-to-hop delivery of messages. From E to F, you are having hop to. So from this A to F, you are having three hop to hop delivery of messages. Okay. So coming on to the network layer, the layer is responsible for transmitting the packets. So here in the packet, only the header will be encapsulated with that of the data format. So from sender to receiver, it mainly focuses on the packet transmission. And what is meant is source to destination delivery. So in the previous term, we have come across hop-to-hop delivery. In this, you are going to deal with source to destination. That is, source is your end system A is the source system, and destination is F. Okay. So between source to destination delivery, you are going to have three hop-to-hop delivery. From this picture, we can understand that three hops are there to reach the destination end system. Yes. Okay. The transport layer, only the header will be encapsulated onto the data format, and it's mainly responsible for the delivery of message from one process to another process. Okay. So transport layer, as we have seen earlier, transport layer is mainly responsible for the reliable transmission. So one process to another process. For example, so here is one system dealing with three processes. The same thing, you're going to deliver, consider process A to A, B, C, that is running on the system, sender system A. And at the receiving side, three processes running on the system. Okay. Suppose if the process A on the sender side has to be transmitted to the receiving side, or they want to communicate in between that the transmission, reliable transmission means so there won't be any interruption in between the transmission. That will be taken care of the transport system. So network layer will be delivering the host to host delivery, and transport layer will be taking responsibility of process to process delivery. So a particular system may can go for running three or more processes. What do you mean by process? That is, it can go for running two or three programs. Okay. So the session layer in this also, you can see the data as a segment. Okay, header will be encapsulated with the data format. So session layer mainly responsible for synchronization of the messages, and dialog control is also maintained in the from one session source system to destination system. And presentation layer is responsible for the three main functionalities carried out. One is translation of message, which is from the sender format to the receiver format. And the compressions, if the message or the information is too long, then the presentation layer will be doing the compression techniques using some compression algorithms. It will go for compressing the information passed on to the destination system. And encryption is also done. So three main functionality, translation, compression and encryption, will be done by the presentation layer. And application layer is mainly responsible for providing services to the user. Okay. User is the main place, the main role here. Okay. So let's we have come to the summary of all the seven layers that we have seen for the OSI model, starting from physical layer to application layer. So let me summarize all the functionalities. The physical layer is mainly responsible for transmission of bits over the transmission medium to provide the mechanical and the electrical specification. And coming on to the data link layer, it is it has a responsibility of transmitting the frames, that is organizing the bits into frames. So it will be converting, it will be receiving the bit format of data, and that bits will be converted into frames, and it will be providing the hop to hop delivery of messages. And network layer will be responsible for packet transmission from source to destination to provide the networking. And transport layer will be providing the reliable process to process delivery of messages, and it also deals with the error recovery also. Session is a session layer mainly responsible for establishing the connections and managing the sessions, and also for terminating the sessions. So session management will be done by the session layer, and presentation layer will be doing three main functionality: translation of message, encryption and compression of data will be performed at the presentation. Application layer will be allowing access to the network resources to the users. Okay. Let's come on to the next the second model, that is the TCP and IP model, TCP IP model. So the TCP IP model comes from the version, or we can say it in another manner, it's the concise version of the OSI model. Okay, so it was designed to describe the functions of the communication system by dividing the communication procedure into simpler and smaller components. But TCP/IP model is based on the standard protocol. So it stands for Transmission Control Protocol and Internet Protocol. So TCP/IP is the concise version of the OSI model. Okay. So we have already seen OSI model. In that, we have seen seven layers and what are the functionalities of seven layers we have seen. That we are going to compare with the TCP/IP model. So the physical and the data link layer is combined to have a single layer that is called as access layer, or in other words, we can say a host layer, host to network layer, we can say it like that. And the next layer in OSI, network layer, is also same as the internet work layer in TCP/IP. Transport layer is similar in both OSI and TCP. Presentation, session layer, and application layer. All the three layers are combined to have as a single layer as application layer in the TCP/IP model. Okay. So this is a pictorial representation of TCP/IP protocol suite, which has defined having four layers. The first layer is host network, and the second layer is network layer, and the third layer is transport layer, and fourth layer is application layer. Okay, so the layers in TCP/IP protocol should do not exactly match with the OSI model. However, TCP is compared to the OSI, we can say TCP/IP protocol suite is made up of five layers. So that is physical layer and data link layer, network layer, transport layer, and application layer. So TCP/IP model, we can say four layers. It can have four layers or five layers. That is, host network is similar to that of physical and data link layer and OSI model. So here you can have TCP/IP model, that is at the data link layer in TCP. You can have the usage of protocols like ARP protocol, RARP protocol, there is Ethernet protocols, and point-to-point protocols. And at the network layer, in the TCP/IP layer, you can use the protocols like Internet protocol, ICMP protocol, IGMP protocol. Okay. And at the transport layer, you can use the protocols like transmission control protocol and user data grant protocol. These are the main two protocols playing main role in transport layer. And at the application layer, you can have so many number of protocols used in TCP/IP model. One is HTTP, that is Hypertext Transfer Protocol, is SMTP, then POP3, File Transfer Protocol, etc. Okay, these are the protocols. So TCP/IP model, mainly they are based on the standard protocols used in each and every layer. Okay. So coming on to the application layer of TCP/IP model, it is equivalent to the combined OSI model, that is session, presentation, and application layer. All these three layers are combined to have an application layer in the TCP/IP model. So all the three functionality of three layers in OSI model will be handled by the application layer in TCP/IP. So this layer contains all the higher level protocols such as file transfer protocol, that is FTP. So it can go for transferring the files from one node to another node. Then SMTP, that is simple mail transfer protocol, which is mainly, this protocol is mainly useful for the email, transfer of email from one person to another person. And HTTP, there is Hypertext Transfer Protocol for web browsing. We'll be using, you might have seen in the browser that HTTP colon slash, okay. So this main HTTP protocol acts in the application layer of the TCP/IP model, okay. So the data unit created at this application layer, we call it as a message, okay. Next comes the transport layer in the TCP/IP. The two main protocols acting upon this transport layer, one is the transmission control protocol and user data grant protocol. Okay, so TCP is a reliable connection oriented protocol, and user data grant is a connectionless protocol. So TCP allows the error free transmission also. At the receiving end, TCP reassembles all the messages to the to an output stream, and it also handles the flow control management also. UDP is a self-contained message unit, which contains the sufficient information to allow it to be routed from source to destination. So it is very simpler, but used when reliability and security are less important, the size and speed such as size, speech, video. Network layer, it is also referred to network layer or otherwise called as inter-network layer. It performs the error checking process. So error checking algorithms like CRC algorithms, used at this network layer, and datagrams are discarded due to the time of layers. Okay, so all the functionalities of TCP/IP layers we have seen can go for comparing the OSI model and TCP/IP model. That is, OSI is having 7 layers, while TCP/IP is having 5 layers. Okay, both have the network, transport, and application layer, but other layers are different in the TCP/IP. Okay, OSI model supports the both the connection list and the connection oriented, but TCP/IP model supports only the connection list communication. This was the comparison of OSI model and TCP model. And in textbook, we can see TCP/IP model will be comprising of 5 layers: physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, and application layer. So in the previous slide, we have seen 4 layers. So according to the textbook, we can say TCP/IP model can have 5 layers. Okay, this overlap of both the models, OSI and TCP/IP. What are the protocols used in each and every layer, which we have already seen in the previous slide. Okay, next we can come on to the addressing part. So previously we have seen two reference models. One is the OSI model and the other one is TCP/IP model. Next comes the addressing. There are 4 levels of addresses are used in an internet. Okay, the addresses are clustered into physical address, logical address, port address, and specific addresses. So these addresses are playing a main role in each layer. Okay, we'll see one by one. Okay, so these 4 kinds of addresses are acting on the specific layers in TCP/IP, or otherwise called as internet model. So physical addresses will be mainly acting upon the physical and data link layer. Okay, and logical address will be acting upon the network or internet work layer, and port address will be acting upon the transport layer. Okay, and specific address will be acting upon the application layer. So these are the 4 main addresses acting upon the each and every layer. So what is meant by physical address? You can say physical address or system. Every system will be holding the physical address. We'll say it as a MAC address or a link address. The address of the node as defined by its LAN connection or WAN connection. So it is included in the frame. So this physical address will be included in the frames. So at which layer will be using the frame? Data link layer. So this thing will be used at the data link layer. It is the lowest level address. So consider, to understand the physical address, an example. So you might, you can clearly watch this slide. Okay, a node with a physical address 10, that is the sender, and a node which is having the 87, address 87 is the receiver. So in between, 2 other nodes also connected having the physical address 28 and 53. So sender is going to be having the physical address 10, going to transmit some message to the receiver having the physical address 87. Okay, so all the 4 systems are connected in a LAN. Okay, next comes the logical address. So logical address in the internet is currently 32-bit address. Can also have 64-bit address also, that uniquely define a host connects to the internet. It's no 2 publicly addressed and visible hosts on the internet can have the same IP address. So no 2 hosts can have the same IP address. Okay, so IP address is the typical example of logical address on the present day internet. Okay, so let's to understand the logical address, we are going to have a example, that is 2 routers connecting 3 LANs. You can see here, so LAN 1, LAN 2 and LAN 3 are connected in with the via the 2 routers. Okay, So here you can see sender A going to be the transmit some message to the destination one. Okay. Each device will be having a pair of addresses. So each system will be holding physical address as well as the logical address, that is IP address for each connection. So in this, each computer is connected to only one link. So therefore, each link will be having only one pair of address. But each router is connected to three LANs. So this router 1 is connected with the LAN 1 as well as LAN 2. This router 2 is connected between LAN 2 and LAN 3. Each router is connected to 3 networks, LAN 1, LAN 2 and LAN 3. So each router will be having 3 pairs of address for each connection. Okay. 3 pairs in the sense, 3 IP addresses as well as 3 physical addresses pertaining to the each system. Okay. Okay. Let's come to the port address. The port address will be playing the main role in transport layer. Okay. In TCP/IP model, the label assigned to a process is called a port address. So a port in TCP/IP model is 16 bits in length. Okay. To understand the port address, can have the example two computers communicating via the internet. So here you can see sender A is going to communicate with the receiver P. So in between, the port address will be playing the main role here. Sender A is having three processes running on the sender A. That is process A, B and C. Okay. And at the receiving side, two processes carried out, process J and K. Okay. So the sending computer is running three processes at this time with the port address A, B and C. And the receiving computer is running two processes with the port address J and K. So the process A in the sending computer needs to communicate with the A is going to communicate from sender A to the receiver, A is going to be communicated with the J, okay, with the help of the port address. So you can clearly understand that the physical address changed from node to node, and the logical and the port address remains the same from source to destination. That's the point I have to insist here. So from machine to machine, the physical address will be changing, but the IP address and the port address will be remaining the same from source to destination. Okay. The physical address change from hop to hop. There is nothing but from one node to another node. That is, we call that as a hop to hop delivery or node to node delivery. Okay. But the logical and the port address remain the same from source to destination. The last address which we are going to see is the specific address. So this we call as a user friendly address, which is designed at the level of application layer. We call that as a specific addresses. One is email address and the website address, which we are commonly using. And these are the references. So thus we have come to the end of the today's session. So let me conclude today's session. We have seen layered tasks. So what are the two reference models we have seen is the OSI model and TCP/IP model. Then we have seen what are the four different types of addresses. One is physical address, logical address, port address and specific addresses. So these are the references used for preparing the presentation. Thank you, students.